Oh boy. Oh, give me a minute. Well, that's fine. It will probably not matter. Alright. Let's go. No, hold on. We need to get the full brunt of this intro. We are entering the 3D. Master. Okay. Right. Yeah, that's right. Blaster Master blessing again. That's right. Where are our options here? We're blasting again, as the kids would say. I think this is my first time.
My father was alive.
Oh no.
A story about alien beings that invaded.
He's dead.
Inhabited the ground beneath the earth.
Hold on a second. Something is off with this.
They were like mechanical aliens that were building a nest.
Yeah, give me just like 2 minutes here. I gotta do some things. Hold on, let me.
Deep under the ground.
No.
With their great.
Hold on, we're gonna reset it in a minute anyway. Let me. I'm trying to fix this text because it's not looking healthy.
They caused upheavals in the earth, threatening humanity.
1 second. Display settings. Yeah, I'm.
My father in his combat vehicle, Sophia.
That's better. But. Let me see here.
The third was the brave one who defeated the plutonium boss, but his bravery cost him, and my father succumbed to death. In combat, he fell into the enemy's trap.
Okay, well, this is about as good as that's gonna get. Damn. Alright. Coming back. Thanks to Dog Station for getting your GUI in the way. Oh, baby, it's Sunsoft. Oh, baby, it's loading. Oh, baby, accessing memory card. Do not remove memory card. Oh, baby. That's right, no blaster. Alright, Blaster Master. Okay, alright. Well, I gotta go into a hole in the ground. So, yeah. Option. Let's get this opening cinema.
My was alive.
Yeah?
He told me a story about alien beings that invaded and inhabited the ground beneath the earth.
Huh?
They were lightning beings, mechanical aliens that were building a nest deep under the ground. And with their great power, they caused upheavals in the earth, threatening humanity. My father, in his combat vehicle, Sophia III, was the brave one who defeated the plutonium boss.
Plutonium boss.
Bravery cost him, and my father succumbed to death. In combat, he fell into the enemy's trap. My mother died of an illness when I was 9, so my sister Elfie and I had to survive without relying on anyone but ourselves. We didn't know it then, but it was only a matter of time before another night.
She's the one that says.
Check complete. Sis. Navigation is in your hands.
Okay, leave it to me. How's Sophia today?
Great.
Alright.
You did a good job as always, Elfie.
Good. It's only reconnaissance again. No nonsense. Okay, Roddy?
That's right, naughty Roddy.
Shall we start?
Great. Alright. Woohoo! Woohoo! Yeehoo! Let's figure it out together. Oh. Okay. The lamp in the bottom left hand corner of the screen flashes. I open the communication line by pressing the sub window button. Got it? Great. All right. Oh, disorienting. Okay. Well, at least there's auto-aim. Whoa, whoa. Uh-huh. I can see why they didn't exactly try, well, they kinda couldn't because they shut down their development studio for, like, 10 years after this. So, but they were, apparently, there was a plan before they closed the studio, there was a plan to do, like, an enhanced version of this for GameCube, but they, before it even got started, they were done making console games. Oh, there we go. See here. There's some power. Oh, where are we at? I constantly forget about, like, the really weird perspective textures in PS1 games. Especially stuff that should have, like, stuff that should have supported the dual analog, but didn't. Like, this conceivably could have supported that, but, Oh, Sophia. Is that all you have to say to me? Oh, okay, well. Good news, I can get out of the ship again, still. I wonder if I still have ridiculous fall damage models. Like that would have killed me in the 2D Blaster Master games. There we go. Okay, so I guess this is the way. Or no, it's not. It's just... Nice. Wait, am I gonna... Is this the thing that pushed the story along? Going through this gate? Yeah, I do. Oh, hi. Where are we at? Oh, no. Okay, now you take care too. You're apparently the only family member I have left. Somehow. For reasons unknown. Moving on. Oh, hello. I thought it was a different. Okay. Now, I can believe a lot about these Blaster Master games, but I just can't believe that they... Okay. And blew up some rocks. I also like that out of four games in, they, Sunsoft gets hip to the fact that, if you make a Metroidvania, you gotta have some kind of weird, variant of spiders in it, but even though that's more like just regular bugs. Oh. I'm underwater. I don't have the dive module yet. Woe is me. Yeah, oh. So it's a box of nail gun ammunition from Quake, just firing rockets at me. All right. Where am I at now in relation to... I am... I guess I have to go through all these side rooms to... Loop to... Oh, okay. Is that all you wanted to say to me? Okay, you take care too. This feels like music from 18-wheeler Pro American Trucker. Okay. That's what the green thing was. Okay. I get it. I get what you're putting down, Blaster Master. Blasting again? I'm gonna guess. What? No! I can't believe I rolled backwards. Off the ledge that I was trying to get to. Right to the beginning of the room. Oh well. Yeah. Yeah. We should probably use the D-pad since that's what it was made for in the first place. The analog stick seems to have a little bit too much give in it, so. Especially with this game, so. Oh no, is that the same? What did I do? I blew it up. Ronnie. Concentrate on the bat. I'm trying. I'll concentrate more if you stop calling me. To go back anyway because that's poison. Okay. I should have probably shot that one, post a little more. Never too late. Remember you? You were the one that was stuck in the wall. Okay. I don't know. Earth's crust. Anyway, you died. And there's the one from Blaster Master 2. Or 3. Oh, there was never one in Blaster Master 2. Real rock to the max. I think that Shadow Dad should do an alternative soundtrack to this. I say the Chowder Dad. I meant the Chowder Man. Or Hot Dad. I don't care. One of those two guys. This is a very... I don't know. This song is a very buying auto parts. For a 1986 Corvette soundtrack. Which I guess is what they were going for. Hmm. Oh. Think that's probably, yeah, one more. Napa Auto Parts. Get in the zone, Auto Zone. O'Reilly Auto Parts. No, they wouldn't. They wouldn't fake being that cool. They're. No, Advanced Auto Parts would though. Because Advance wants to be AutoZone, and they're not. Hello. I was just goofing on the music on this, in this game. How it sounds like soundtracks for buying car parts. But, how are you? Thanks for stopping by, by the way. I'm making it. Falling off the edge of a ledge there, but I'm making it. Just I don't know. Schedule's been all weird because of fatigue issues, but it's fine. Cause I had some time where I was playing well where I am in the more in like the you know middle late morning and afternoon. And then things got all messed up, so I'm back to playing at nights again. Oh my. There we go. Now I played through the I'm basically going through the entire Blaster Master series. And just finished Enemy Below for the Game Boy Color. And so this was the next one. Blasting again. I think it's their only 3D game in the series. And the one before they... the last Blaster Master they made before they... before Sunsoft stopped making games for about 10 years. Or stopped game development. They were still publishing, but they... They reorganized a lot of their operations. They also, this is like when they closed down the American division and the European division as well. Oh, that's a safe spot. Okay. Because I had heard from elsewhere that this was supposed to get like a. Like a remaster or whatever on GameCube, but before the GameCube even came out, Sunsoft had already stopped making new games, so those plans kind of went out the window. But I was saying that this sort of suffers because it doesn't natively support the DualShock, and you would think that it probably would. Ah, there we go, falling down a pit again. Let me try this again. I'm gonna load from the save point. Nice. Might just have to make judicious use of quick saves. this one. Especially with all the platforming. Okay. I gotcha. Yeah, I may as well use quick saves because these load times on memory cards I forgot can sometimes take a while. Slows everything down. It's whatever. Ooh. Okay. Is this my way forward? Yeah, I know. I know, and it's like, you sort of forget, after so long, you sort of forget because you're so used to, like, modern conveniences and stuff. There's a lot of, that's how it goes. Are basically beholden to what the hardware or what the emulated hardware does. So, oh my. Nope. Hold on just a second, I'll be right back. I got this. I'll do this one more time. Unfortunately. You know what? Nah. Never mind. We're just gonna roll with this. Get out of here. It is not that far. Yeah, It came out like, a little while after the Game Boy Color, game. Because they did a, they did sort of a semi-remake of the first Blaster Master game on, the Game Boy Color, called, Enemy Below, and I just finished playing that one. And, honestly, it kinda doesn't hold up as well as the NES Blaster Master, because there's some mechanics that they did better and some mechanics that they managed to somehow do worse. I don't know, it was, it's weird. There's a lot of, there's a lot of strange things with the maps and, oh, with how your, abilities work. And so that was, it was odd. And then, I don't know, I didn't like, I kind of thought, I keep messing this up. Alright, never mind. We're just not even gonna bother with that. I just have to take these jumps one at a time, I guess. Yeah, they did, but yeah, the first game that Sunsoft made when they came back to game development was, actually Blaster Master Overdrive for WiiWare, and that was kind of a reboot too, as far as going back to the original games, or going back to the original games, so... It's kind of the second. I mean, it's not even like a real remake. It's like a, basically a whole new version of the first game, I guess, is what you could say. But there was a lot going on with it, so. Is this the... No? Oh, here we go. Okay. Alright. Alright, first things first. Save, I think. Load. Huh. There we go. Save. Whoa. Not doing that again. Need that, so I'm not gonna get it. There we go. Okay, what's okay? There's something I'm missing here. Maybe. Huh. Yeah, this is... I was always weirdly interested in this. Like, I was always weirdly interested in, I don't know if you remember when they did the 3D Metal Slug game. I was like, huh, that's weird. How are they gonna make that work? And I don't know. I don't know if they necessarily made it work here, but they tried, I guess. I think they're trying to do their... SNK was talking about doing 3D Metal Slug again. I don't know. I'm not, This was like a couple of years ago when they said that. I don't know if plans changed or not, but... yeah. Let me see if I can go through that thing again. There's a door. Well, there's something up there. I think. Yeah, there's, I don't think I can do anything about that one. Yeah, I need to be Alright, well, thanks. That is poison. Nope. Not going that way. But yeah, for the longest time I thought that it was, who was it? I thought it was Natsume that published this in the US. But no, it was Crave Entertainment. Same folks that published Shadow Madness. And all the Tokyo Highway Battle games. Oh, I miss those games. I wish there was another one. But I think Genki's gone out of business since, I think, what, 2013? They folded? I don't remember. But those are some good racing games. Where am I? Oh, I'm here. Yes, yes. All right. Yeah, that starts powering up again. Okay. Hmm. But yeah, usually I'm playing a lot of Metroidvanias during the weekdays. So this is sort of part of that. And I guess this is sort of a lot more of an open-ended Metroidvania than I thought, because I'm seeing some sealed doors around here. And well, there were some interesting experiments in 3D on the PlayStation, so as far as, like, you know, exploratory type games. So there was this, and Power Slave, which or Exhumed, which was I guess more notable on the Saturn, but there was a PlayStation version too, so. And then the Divide Enemies Within. Which I was always told was a really innovative game as far as that goes. That it was kind of a 3D game influenced by Super Metroid. Just like, yeah, I could get down with that. So someday I'm gonna play that for sure. Oh my. There we go. There it is. Oh wait. We were supposed to go to that gate. The one with the lasers. Right. Oh, okay, so this is the all right. Got it. There we go. There's another energy surface. I've indicated the spot. Okay. Oh, there we go. Okay, don't use that then, unless I need to. Okay. So my triggers are my camera rotation, and the bumpers. L1 and R1. Strafe jumping. That's bombs. And then the top button is the weird sort of supernova room sweeper thing. That's fire and that's jump. Oh. Oh, okay, well. I didn't mean to do that, but whatever. Hold on. That's hilarious. Oh, that's why that happened. Not that I don't need no, I know that I don't need to go that way. Eh. So that exit's not an exit? Oh, alright. It just... It just yeets me out of the room. Waste my time with that room over there until I have to. So. Anymore. Alright. Through the Cool Z. my. I'm going to at least try to take out the first boss, or wherever that is. Yes. Okay. You've detected another energy source. Cool. Oh, cool. You got gun upgrades as well. That's neat. I mean, okay. Yeah, I mean, as far as making a 3D game that feels like a Blaster Master, they're all right. Yeah, I like that. Oh. If it takes me to a game over screen, I'm just gonna laugh. Okay, cool. You blew up the reactor core with yourself in it. Game over. Thank you. Yikes. Alright, I need to go back to that first room because there's another door that I didn't go to yet. There goes, gun up. Nice. What do we got in here? What? All right. Nope. Well, that's fine. Anything? Guess not. That's fine. Well then. Just in case. Oh. Maybe. So the activation unit. Check the vicinity once more, would you? Yeah, of course. I'm gonna. From here, I go north. Okay. Let's just use these, platforms and just sort of. All right. A door open. Oh, that's where the awful platforms are.
Roddy? Roddy?
How do I? I thought you could warp me back. Oh well. My sister in this game did this whole spiel about how she could bring me back to Sophia wherever I am, and it's like, no, I have to walk back. What a jerk. Oh. Oh gosh. Oh. Forget it then. I'm just gonna walk without you and just not even bother shooting you. Oh yeah.
Ryan?
I feel. I know how to press the select. Oh, is that what you meant? You're just gonna transfer me when I'm standing next to it? Okay. I know how to press the select button. Or, you know. Okay, oh, I'm so used to the mechanics of getting in and out of my tank boat car thing manually that. It's fine. A little laughable, but no, this is what I meant. I meant I'm going to transfer you 10 feet. All right. Now save the game. Okay, and save state. But although as much fun as I had with the NES Blaster Master when I played it a few days ago, and as much as I'm actually liking this, I really can't wait until I get to the Zero series. It's not gonna be that long. It's okay. Well, yeah, it's a mound of dirt. It's huge. Oh no, what? Oh, they're giving me boss fights in Sophia now. Okay. Cool. Warning, 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 warning. This shaking warning really goes well with my overlay. Oh, wow. Well, I'm close to taking some of these components offline. I don't know which ones. Neat! That was a cool boss fight!
Roddy? Are you okay?
You forgot to say Roddy again.
I'm fine. All systems still A-okay.
I can't believe you weren't hurt. How could you survive?
What can I say? Despite that I only have minimal equipment.
Listen, Roddy. Father wouldn't have argued like that.
What?
I understand.
Uh-huh.
But I would have liked to know what that was back there.
It was a robot.
That was one of the lightning beings.
I never met that lightning.
A lightning being that big still existed.
I never met that lightning being before.
I feel like something else is behind this, though.
The lightning beings are building robots?
The plutonium boss, you think?
Ah.
Couldn't be. But...
Couldn't be. We... But mom,
let's go.
Dad,
already,
Dad barbecued him.
Well, okay, but listen to one thing I have to say. I'm going to send Sophia's optional parts to the top level. You need to take them, okay? With those parts, you'll be much stronger. Got that?
Roger.
But Roddy, always be careful. And don't go in over your head.
You just wait and see.
The cutscenes. Oh, That's PlayStation 1 cutscenes, alright. Alright. components to the nearby maintenance truck. Alright. Oh. The world of components. Homing. Okay. Setup complete. All right. So okay, yeah. Huh. Well, this is a rearrangement of the old Blaster Master theme. At least the old Stage 1 theme. Okay. In any case, I'm about to sign off, I think. I've been on for roughly 5.5 hours now, if you count my previous 4+ hour stream, so maybe even up to 6 hours, I don't remember, but anyway. I've made a lot of progress. I think this might end up being shorter than the other games, but I don't know, so we'll see. And, Saturday I'm going to pick up Disco Elysium some more. Play that on Saturday and Sunday. Monday and Tuesday, keep playing Blaster Master. And then we'll see what happens from there. Alright. Look, I'm trying to monologue here about my schedule. Alright. May as well. Okay. Took care of that. Let's save. Alright, so thanks for watching. Thanks for stopping by. Plenty of time. Please stop by us and visit again soon. Hopefully I will see anybody that tunes in tomorrow. I'm aiming for an earlier start time tomorrow, so just so I can get some work done in the evening and some outside work. But all right, that's about it for me. Good night.